It's Bob and Tom Tonight, starring Chick McGee, Christy Lee, Josh Arnold, Ace Cosby, Pat Godwin, Willie Griswold, and Tom Griswold.
And now, our leader, Tom Griswold.
Thank you very much. Glad to be here.
Take us to our leader.
As the man said, I'm glad to be anywhere. Rough day yesterday.
Tom had a bad day.
No need to go into that.
No, there isn't. What else is going on?
That's where we're moving on right now.
I caught the early show. He was still talking about it.
No, I didn't bring it up. Other people did.
You're better now?
Yes.
Well, how did other people find out if you didn't bring it up?
Well, when someone said, how are you?
When somebody says, how are you, Josh? You go, oh, man, yesterday I had diarrhea. Would you say that?
Well, most people mean it rhetorically, don't they?
Absolutely.
How are you?
Nobody cares.
If somebody starts to answer, I don't mind. I don't mind.
Oh, he doesn't lie, I guess, and say, oh, it was great.
I've always been horrible. I'm okay saying hi and how are you, but then anything more than that, I don't know how to get out of the conversation. I'm done. I'm done.
Find yourself on a freeway going, okay, where is the nearest toilet?
Uh-oh.
You do that a lot.
We got a problem.
That happened yesterday.
And I stopped here.
Oh, God.
You know that feeling where you're cursing every red light? Don't go left, you son of a...
Let me tell you something. He looks forward to stuff like this.
You must, because
you do it all the time.
Yeah, this is his fuel. He needs this.
These are lies.
As you're driving out of the parking lot, you're thinking, who can I call? to mess up their day? And
I did not call anyone.
Where's the nearest bathroom?
Didn't answer my phone. That thing where you finally find a place, you get the launch codes are off, and you get up there, and they've got that yellow cone in front of it.
Oh, no.
Do you have any idea how bad this is going to be? Let's just move forward.
You're
here.
Really something.
I'll introduce everyone properly. We have Christy Lee at the Navy Federal Credit Union News Desk. She's right there.
Hi.
We have is it the birthday boy almost?
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, that's
Josh
right.
Arnold. Is Sunday the official birthday?
It is, yeah.
Thank
you for reminding me.
I'm surprised May hasn't been the Josh Arnold birthday month. I mean.
Well, we're gearing up, of course. If you look at our electronic board over there, it has today's date, and it says 79 days until Josh's fifth anniversary.
My goodness.
And that falls on a Sunday, so we're going to do a Friday and Monday celebration.
Is that right?
I think it's deserved. Yes,
we've already started working on various aspects of the celebration.
Are we going to play Josh's greatest hit?
Is that going to be played?
In the meantime, Mr. Godwin might have something over there in the Oxford Gold Performance Room. Coming up today, we've got some nice requests for some songs from Patty G. We'll look forward to that. And when that phone rings, it's, of course, the track phone hotline. Now, I may be incorrect here. I was very quickly trying to go over some stuff, and am I correct? Ace? And as I have said that I'm going to be sending you to Las Vegas to see your favorite football team in their new stadium. The schedule was just released. Is the Washington Football Club going to be playing in Vegas?
Yes.
Yeah. Toward the end of the season,
the top six ticket season, five of them are Raider games, and one of them, the number one, is Patriots and Bucks.
Okay,
but
the point here is...
You could send Chick, too?
We could have a road trip.
Hey, me and
Ace and Chick...
Share a room.
Together. Oh, even better. Share a room in Vegas.
film every minute.
You travel via smart car.
Oh, boy.
And you have to share rooms.
So we have more time to chat.
Yeah. Every 4 hours.
A driverless car.
Every 4 hours you need to park.
We can listen to the same music.
Here you go. A little Bon Jovi for you.
Get an electric car, so you have to charge it on the way. You can't just fill it up conveniently. You got to wait where you are. 4 hours in Peoria, 4 hours in St. Louis, 4 hours. Yeah, it'll be fun.
My God. About the only reason, the only way I would do that is to get me to appreciate everyday life. Well, it could be worse. It could be back on the road with Ace. Yeah, you're right. You're right.
Had a request here before we polish off sports. There was a big story last week about the opening of a White Castle hamburger place in Orlando. And it's mm-hmm. as I recall, Christy, it's the biggest one.
Yeah, over 4,500 square feet in Orlando. And the lines were 4 hours long through the drive-thru.
Wow.
Yeah.
And it's somewhere near Disney
World. It's close to Disney World. By Disney Springs.
It's on the Darrell Carter Parkway.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm.
So a big story. And Pat did a special tribute.
Rising up the charts,
along with Dean on the 12 string. just for those of you not familiar with White Castle, real quick, Josh, it's kind of got a regional footprint.
Yeah.
A bit, yep. And
famous for the late night drive through and
sure, yeah. Little square burgers. Yeah, they're great. The sliders is where that sort of term originated from.
And they've embraced the sliders.
Yes, yeah. Because it kind of meant, hey, they slide right
through you.
Yeah, but now people we love them.
Slide right down the hatch.
And you have all these fancy restaurants now. You'll go in and they'll have their own version.
They call them
the Kobe beef slider.
Exactly. Yeah,
$40. What?
We always called them Whitey One Bites when I was a kid.
Okay. Yeah.
Whitey One Bites.
Oh, you can just shove one in and just one at a time.
I love them.
They are.
What's the record,
really
Willie?
Delicious.
What'd you say?
What's the record for your White Castle eating?
Me and a buddy will get one. We'll get a Crave case. So I've done 16 before.
That's Crave case. Now is that wind aided by wind? I mean pot.
Oh, I mean guaranteed. There's a little bit of pot going on. A little bit of booze, and it's your buddies. You can eat more when your friends are around.
Pat, this is a tribute to the White Castle.
Yes, of course, yeah. Combo 1, 2, 3.
That's
Godwin giving us his best Stevie Nicks.
Lines at White Castle since 9 a.m. Tiny square burgers. I'll take a sack of 10. They're new to Orlando. Onions, pickles, and cheese. Folks call them sliders, 'cause they slide out with ease. We love you. Yes, we love you. Whoa, yeah.
Chick, we're gonna need you. Here we go.
A tribute to White Castle and our apologies to the Moody Blues.
And everyone who's ever recorded music.
When the organ kicks in, I don't know why that's hilarious.
Tom, if you don't mind, I have not rehearsed this or anything, but when I found out we were doing the song again today, I wrote a quick song.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, how nice.
Try.
Lovely.
He likes White Castles and old prog rock songs. He makes up fake requests, and we all play along.
Yeah, everyone.
Ooh, what a nutty man he is.
Thank you very much.
Ooh, what a nutty man he is.
Major third.
My God, that's beautiful.
Oh. How about a little ELP?
Yes, yes.
No, it's CDM.
Oh, yes.
Clayton Dean Metcalf.
Yeah, I got you.
I see. Very good. Thank you very much. And we'll be hearing, of course, the Ace Cosby joke of the day. This is called the tease. No, it's not. It's the real thing.
Oh,
misdirection.
Ace Cosby. Joke of the day.
We've been talking all this week about pasta for some reason.
Oh. Pasta.
And my fiance said, if I don't stop eating pasta, she's going to leave me.
Uh-oh.
Now I'm feeling cannelloni.
That was Ace Cosby's
Kind of lonely?
He's feeling kind of lonely.
Kind of lonely.
Okay. A suggestion. I want you to try it with an Italian accent. Ready? Okay. Now, ladies and gentlemen, this is a rare... I'm doing a little bit of directing here. Can you do an Italian accent? Try the whole thing with an Italian accent. Go ahead.
We've been talking about the pasta a lot.
Yeah, very good. Okay, yes.
My fiance, she say... If I don't stop eating pasta, she's going to leave me.
Oh, no.
Now I'm feeling kind of lonely.
There you go.
Really good.
What's going on? What in the hell?
Oh, it reminds me of my days when
Let's make it longer.
Well, it reminds me of the days when I would coach great blues artists on their albums.
Really?
Yeah, sorry. Listen, Ray, I don't need no doctor. It's a double negative. Could you go with I don't need a doctor, Ray?
Or I don't need any doctor?
Yes, that would be your...
Is that what you're trying to say?
Yeah, yeah. So. Then maybe when...
I'm just saying they would have changed it from the blues to the whites.
Tutti frutti.
Oh, Rudy. Oh, there's the phone.
Hello, Bob and Tom Show.
Hey, Bob and Tom, it's Donnie Baker.
Good morning, sir.
Yeah, I don't need a doctor neither. I need a lumberjack. You guys seen the price of lumber lately?
Yes.
My goodness.
Real high. It's gone up like 400%. You know, last year it cost like $1,000 in lumber to build a deck. But today, if you want to build one, you got to take out a reverse mortgage.
Yes,
you do. Swear to God.
Oh, yeah.
I don't get it. Like, are the trees on strike, Tom?
No.
Are they hiding in the forest? Like the famous Greek president Pluto once said, sometimes you can't see the forest for the trees. Well, then I say cut them down.
Donnie, I think the pandemic has impacted the... affected, if you will, the lumber supply chain.
Would the Bradford pears not wear their masks? Look, Tom, it's a pretty simple thing. You cut down a tree, throw it in a truck, drive it to a place that's a big circular saw, have them make it into some boards, throw them in the back of the truck, and take them Home Depot to be treated with barcodes.
Okay.
Well,
it's a little more complicated than that.
No need to be bringing chains into the process. It ain't like it's rocket science. Where lately they keep inventing rockets that blow up and fall into somebody's backyard. Mm-hmm. And I'm talking to you, China. You know, my mom Phyllis wants me to build her a gazebo, but thanks to lumber, it's going to be too expensive.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, and spoiler alert, gazebo is a French word meaning dumb outside room with no walls.
I didn't know that.
Swear to God. My mom Phyllis says she wants to sip on champagne in her gazebo like rich people do.
Nice.
Yeah, I bought her a case of White Claws, told her she could drink it in the back of my cousin Chantel's Winnebago like our people do. Uh-huh. You know her, Christy. Chantel's my white trash cousin.
Oh, yeah.
She was like, pretend like she's rich. She always carries these famous purses around. But we know you got that Louis Vuitton handbag at Liberty Bell Flea Market, Chantel. Because everybody knows Gucci ain't spelled with a C-H. I mean, watch Wheel of Fortune. Plus, she's always buying stuff she can't afford. Like, she's always buying front row seats and VIP passes for Demolition Derby at the State Fair each year.
Wow, nice.
I mean, I could see if it was county. Of course, every year when the fair comes to town, she always hooks up with one of the carnies. I swear to God.
Oh.
Now that way she gets all the free rides and avoids paying market price for Midnight Madness. All she got to do is give him a tuggy behind the scrambler.
Oh.
Anyway, thinking I'll go over to my neighbor's and chop down some trees in Mitchell's yard. See if I'd sell them for crazy money. Tom, I'll cut you in 10%.
Okay, thanks.
I gotta go.
Don't cut the tree. Let's get the tree stuff done. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to sing because it's Josh's birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Josh.
Oh,
happy birthday to you.
Thank you so much, everybody.
What in the world is
and
that?
And these look amazing, if I may. They're cupcakes, but these aren't your these aren't your mother's cupcakes.
Yeah.
You know
oh, really?
They look to be meatloaf based with a mashed potato icing with bacon bits.
Are you
incredible?
They're meatloaf cupcakes. We were talking about them last year, and Josh said he loved them. So
now the problem is I'm 43, and there are only 8 here.
There's another round of them in the other room.
Woo-hoo!
Yeah, let's go. Start a fire, baby.
Meatloaf cupcakes. Amy made them with mashed potatoes on the top.
All right.
They're really good.
They're good? Okay. Yeah. Dean's eating one right now.
Oh, these look great.
Now, we do have other ones, so if he blows the candles out and salivates all over those, we're still okay.
Okay. I was just going to take the candles off and douse, or, you know.
Yeah. Either blow them out one at a time.
Well, so that would still...
Remove the candle and then make a separate wish for each one. What are you wishing for? Can you tell us?
He tells you it doesn't come true. Tell.
Oh, that's what happens?
Yes.
He's still there.
Chick's having a coronary.
And Josh couldn't be more pleased.
Hey, Josh.
Willie.
Josh, why did you pick him?
All right. Now let's see if the second wish works.
Go!
All right. Now the third.
Hold on to your pants, Christy.
Oh, no.
Yeah!
Oh! Okay. Christy started taking her pants off.
Yeah. Wow. Party girl.
Now, we got into an argument off the air about this case in Ohio in which, speaking of meatloaf, a woman hit her sworn enemy, apparently, with a giant thing of ground beef.
A log of ground beef, yes.
I assume it was probably a frozen log of ground beef.
Probably.
Because that would probably hurt.
Mm-hmm.
I can't believe we played that and didn't play at least this.
Hamburger!
The great comedian Hamburger, who we hope to get on the show one day. Yeah,
I'd love it.
We can put the rest of those in the fridge, Josh. They look absolutely delicious.
I think they just came out of the fridge.
Are they a little chilly?
Microwave. Huh. Christy Lee is once again at the Navy Federal Credit Union News Desk. What's going on over there?
Researchers at the University of Miami have reported that COVID-19 could contribute to erectile dysfunction. According to their study, the coronavirus can result in widespread blood vessel dysfunction, which can prevent the lining of the small blood vessels from performing properly. Researchers' findings suggest that, quote, men who develop COVID-19 infection should be aware that erectile dysfunction could be an adverse effect of the virus, and they should go to a physician if they develop ED symptoms. If you'd like more information, you'll find it in the World Journal of Men's Health.
So that crabby uncle of yours, you might want to be the one who's hesitant to get the vaccine. You might tell him, hey, Elmer.
Yeah,
your wiener's going to stop working. That maybe you'll mask up then and go get yourself vaccinated. I'm waiting for Fauci to come up with one of his famous rhymes, because we remember the Fauci ouchie.
Yes.
So, Dr. Fauci said your male member will be slouchy.
I think it's got to be the Tony Boney, right? I mean, it's right. Tony Boney ain't bad.
Tony Boney no more.
Yeah.
Pat.
Yes, sir.
You were telling me you've got a song that incorporates the mask, so the days of the masks may be winding down. Definitely. God, I hope so.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah. It's weird, though, because I'm so used to now starting to walk in a place, realizing I forgot the mask, going back to my car, cursing, and then putting it on. And if you forget to have one on, you get the look.
Oh, yeah.
I'll be honest. This news means nothing to me. I don't mean to be the pessimist, but in 2 months, you're going to go, no, you need to be wearing the masks again.
Yeah.
Doesn't anybody else see that way?
Yeah, I do.
I don't trust anything these people say.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's because that's your nature.
No, the CDC has proven to be not all that.
They're usually 2 months late. Hey, remember all those gloves and stuff you've been wearing? Turns out it's an aerosol.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, we got it wrong.
I watched The Walking Dead. The CDC hasn't done much for those people.
There you go.
Yeah, they're letting zombies run around all over Georgia, evidently.
Pat, it's my understanding that we have the Bob and Tom Band and Orchestra on this
one. Yeah, they're here.
But you're going to sing it live.
You got it.
Okay, ready?
Yep.
Here we go.
You say your mask is in the way. I can't hear you. Please speak louder, but don't come nearer. We're wearing a mask, trying to talk. All of a sudden, you seem shocked. What I say? Are you pissed? There must be something that I missed. You said, do you like to dance? I thought I heard, drop your pants. Oh, you expressed indignation. Another COVID miscommunication. Masks are on for the whole conversation. I just nod my head and pray for context and enunciation. What'd you say? Your mask is in the way. I can't hear you. Please speak louder, but don't come nearer. I don't drink. It's just too risky. I ordered a soda. They brought me whiskey. Oh. Now it's my third intervention. Another COVID miscommunication. Went to the doctor for a pain in my spine. Couldn't hear me through my mask. So he had my gender reassigned. What'd you say? Your mask is in the way. I can't hear you. Please speak louder, but don't come nearer. I told Christy I liked her sweater. She heard bigger boobs are better. Now HR wants my resignation. Another COVID miscommunication. I can't wait to take off this mask.
All right.
Yeah.
Pat Godwin, Patty G, and the Bob and Tom Band and Orchestra.
I don't know.
A nice arrangement by Steve Ali.
Seems a little exaggerated to me. never had problems hearing somebody. That,
oh, really?
Is that on your album, False Premise?
Watch the entire show live or on demand at bobandtom.com or listen live with the Bob and Tom app. And be sure to tune in next time for more Bob and Tom Tonight.